Today on X-Play, pretty cars go vroom in Project Gotham Racing 2. Some people just aren't photogenic in Fatal Frame 2. Awkward moments in Whiplash.
I can't believe you just set me on fire. Do you know how inappropriate that is?
Sorry, my bad. It's game time. Please welcome minor celebrities Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
I've never worked with Cole.
Welcome to X Play.
Today we have one of the best looking racing games released this year, or probably any year.
And we have a funny platformer, I like funny, with some similarities to Ratchet and Clank.
And there's a kart title for the GBA.
A truly scary game that features a camera and twins.
What could be scary about that? That's just tantalizing.
You'll just have to wait and see. Okay, now for all the Lord of the Rings fans, a Hobbit game from Sierra.
You know, someone was going to cash in on that one sooner or later.
That's true. But we begin tonight with the third installment of a racing series that began in 2001 on the Dreamcast with Metropolis Street Racer.
Right, that may not ring a bell, but the second installment will sound familiar. Project Gotham Racing.
Okay, it sounds like Batman's driving, but there is no Caped Crusader in it. Instead, there's a kudos system which rewards you for driving with style.
Now, here's a review of Project Gotham Racing 2.
Two.
For the Xbox. The sequel to one of the Xbox's top launch titles, Project Gotham Racing 2, is set to renew the franchise's status as the king of the arcade racers. Break out the passports, because you'll be going to fully international racing locales, including the exotic cities of Stockholm, Yokohama, Edinburgh, Barcelona, and Hong Kong. As with the previous Project Gotham, you earn style points called kudos for pulling slick moves while racing, sliding, going up on two wheels, passing close to an opponent, and keeping a good racing line are just some of the ways you can earn kudos. Of course, when you're used to acclaim and accolades like I am, kudos aren't a big deal. However, just like the old game Operation, don't touch the sides. Hit a wall, and you'll lose a good chunk of your kudos points. Gah! Damn you, treacherous metal demon border! This aspect of hazardous driving being balanced with smart racing is what makes PGR 2 such a compelling game. Nailing a great kudos combo is easily as satisfying as winning a race. Project Gotham 2 is a real leaner. That is to say, when you play it, you lean in the direction you want your car to go. Luckily for Morgan, PGR 2 only cares if you look cool in the game.
Shut up! At least I won.
Win, win, win. That's all you ever do. As you progress through the game, you can use kudos tokens to purchase new cars for use throughout the game. As you can see in this showroom, there are tons of pretty automobiles just waiting for you.
Enzo.
Be careful with those gorgeous rides, though. The humanity! Won't someone think of the exotic Italian cars? Don't worry, that damage won't actually affect the car's performance. Unfortunately, it's entirely there for show. If there's one major complaint that can be leveled at Project Gotham Racing 2, it's that the computer opponents are a bit on the cheesy side. They'll slam into you whenever they feel like it, often sending you spinning. Easy, boys. This isn't Gran Turismo. They also hold the racing line like they're glued to it. Move over, you hog. If you get tired of the pattern-addicted computer racers, you can always turn to Xbox Live. PGR 2 is always plugged into Xbox Live, so it can update high scores on every race in the game in real time. It also makes it quick and easy to jump into an online race whenever you like. Xbox Live is so heavily integrated into the Project Gotham 2 experience that you're really missing out on a big part of the game if you don't have a Live account. Project Gotham Racing 2 blows the pants off of most other racing games. If you're already playing your Xbox Online, it's a no-brainer. We give it a 4 out of 5.
If you can't decide which racing title to pick up, I've got a helpful breakdown for you. Now, both PGR and Gran Turismo 4, which comes out later next year, they both look great. But Project Gotham isn't a rigid simulation like the Gran Turismo series. And it has online play with Xbox Live support and has leads.
Now, the Gran Turismo series appeals more to the gearheads. Those are the people who like the details and the tuning of the car and all that. And that game, too, will also have the online
right.
play.
And most importantly, Project Gotham is Xbox exclusive and Gran Turismo is PS2 exclusive, so they might just make your decision for you.
Most likely. Now, in the meantime, Morgan and I are going to show you an aspect of Xbox Live Play called ghosting, right? We're going to look at a downloaded, here it is, right here.
So you download a ghost, and this is the best race on this track with the best score out of 36,000 people who've played this level online. It's, of course, the time of this taping. People are going to run out and
try to beat it right now.
Right.
Yeah, this guy is drafting right here, and he's really tight. No, really, it's actually called tailgating if you do it in the streets for real. But this is drafting. He's right behind the car. If you look there in the upper right-hand corner, you can see all the different kudos that he's stringing together, and he's just racking up those points.
So he's gotten out from behind the car right now so that he can rack up some
more
kudos.
Now he's doing some of the more tricky stuff. He's doing the spins. I mean, he's getting so many points right now. This is some of the most amazing driving I've seen in this game or any driving game.
Yeah, so the white car is actually the computer car, and the blue car is the car that's racking up so many points.
If you want to know, it's a really great way to find out if you're having trouble with a certain course, you can't seem to get out of like a low ranking.
Yeah.
You use this, and boom, maybe you'll be better.
Check out what the big boys are doing.
Yes.
We'll be right back.
What are the big boys doing?
I don't know.
Coming up, making money off The Hobbit.
I've been waiting for you.
And interspecies dating in Whiplash.
X-Play is presented by Xbox. It's good to play together. Live. It's good to play together. Introducing the all-new Toyota Tundra Double Cab. Not just big. Life-sized.
I'm Stanley Johnson. I've got a great family. I've got a four-bedroom house in a great community. Like my car? It's new. I even belong to the local golf club. How do I do it? I'm in debt up to my eyeballs.
Need a smart way to consolidate your debt? At LendingTree.com, you can combine all your separate high-interest charges into one low monthly payment. Call 1-800-555-TREE.
I can barely pay my finance charges.
Right now, you can take advantage of home equity rates as low as 3.75%, and your interest may be tax-deductible.
Somebody help me.
Come to LendingTree.com, where banks compete and you choose the loan that's right for you. When banks compete, you win at LendingTree.com. Call 1-800-555-TREE.
Extreme drinking. Binge eating. Thrill seeking. What happens when people push their bodies to the limits? Watch Tech TV's Body Hits, the only show that examines how your body stands up to the test of modern living. See how people live fast, work hard, and take it to the next level. Body Hits, a new series, premiering Tuesday, January 20th at 9:30, 8:30 Central on Tech TV.
Once again, two people who aren't taking performance-enhancing drugs, and it shows! Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb!
but where does it show?
Welcome back to X-Play. We have a platformer with a great sense of humor.
Now, in it, you actually play two characters who are chained together, a bunny and a crazed weasel. Yes, I said a crazed weasel. Here's our review of Whiplash.
This is different. I'm not talking about the sizable appetite of a greedy global consortium creating comical commercial commodities at the cost of conscripted critters. I'm talking about our heroes here. Spanx, the weasel, and Redmond, the bunny. Look like some sort of plushy hanky-spankies going on between the Velveteen Rabbit and the rat from Ice Age.
I could really use a deep tissue massage.
Genron is up to no good. They're testing on animals to develop products nobody needs. And though animal testing is not funny, this game is. Spanx and Redmond have escaped from Genron's Combinator, which blends creatures for useless hybrids. Years of testing has, of course, endowed our heroes with special abilities.
I can't believe you just set me on fire! You literally set me aflame! Do you know how inappropriate that is?
The weasel's just a tweaker with an appetite for destruction. Redmond the bunny acts as his instrument of devastation, chaos, and calamity. Check me on this, but this is the first time I've ever seen a rabbit chained to a small feral mammal used to put a kibosh on the nefarious intent of corporate greed. Clever is pretty much the lead theme in Whiplash. You'll maneuver Spanx and Redmond through soaring public spaces, thread-lit labs, and intriguing puzzle elements.
You are just as crazy as all get out!
All the while, you'll be liberating hamsters, skunks, and monkeys under the disembodied guidance of Genron's supercomputer.
Your energy, while admirable, is misdirected.
Oh my god! It's the voice from all the movie trailers!
And a few other willing conspirators.
I've been waiting for you.
Over time, you'll gain power and develop a modicum of fighting combos and special abilities. Whiplash tips its hat to a generation bent on mindless mayhem as you try to bankrupt Genron by destroying everything you see. Money is deducted from their weighty coffers as you raise, thrash, and trash them into Chapter 1-1. There's a lot here that widely compares itself to the plethora of puzzling platformers out there. But this game distinguishes itself through its cleverness. Finishing levels allows you to download mysterious content we couldn't quite figure out the use of. This brings to mind some of the downsides of Whiplash. If you like hysterically breaking crap all the time, you'll dig this title. After a while, this can get a bit old. At times, quest directions seem to become needlessly murky as well. But originality and action have to be rewarded here.
It's the Fatress. Yes, the Fatress. The first mattress conceived and designed specifically with the needs of the morbidly obese in mind.
We give it a 4 out of 5.
Morbidly obese. I like this game. It's funny. Now, of course, if the gameplay matched just how funny the game is, it would have had that perfect 5 out of 5.
Moving on, what? We have a Hobbit game, but before you get all excited in a Twitter, we should point something out. This game was not made by EA. No, those are the folks who did the Two Towers and the Return of the King game.
See, EA has the movie license, Sierra has the book license, though I have no memory of Bilbo being killed by wolves in the book. It's a short book. I know it's not there. Anyway, the game also looks nothing like the recent Lord of the Rings games or the films. It looks like the Rankin-Bass Hobbit cartoon from 1977. Here's a review of The Hobbit.
This is the tale of Bilbo Baggins.
Home sweet Hobbit, what happened? I'm small, lazy, and furry, and this hatted homeless guy just invited all his homeless friends over. Now well, let's see what's doing in Hobbiton. It's bright, positive, and everything seems edible and bad for your teeth. It seems some don't want the kiddies to miss out on the magical mayhem of the Tolkien franchise as the Hobbit hits the candy-coated circuits of a console near you.
Hey, Bilbo! Wanna play some hide-and-seek?
Enter Gandalf, who informs you that you're off to recapture the dwarf's pile of treasure from the greedy dragon Smaug. Put on your furry ears, hobbiteers. A standard hack and slash, lever pulling, crystal finding, boulder dodging, and sadly, boredom inducing adventure awaits. See Bilbo jump for mysterious bling. See Bilbo throw stones at wolves. See Bilbo pole vault. See Bilbo fall. Again. And again. There's an awkward in-game camera that makes falling a fairly regular pastime. Combat will cause controller clenching angst as combos reset and the dim hobbit pauses, all the while being shredded to ribbons by the more aggressive inhabitants of Middle-earth. There are some well-rendered environments within the game. I mean, look at this ooze. Feeling low? Mr. Mushroom will get you back on your feet.
Mystical mushroom.
Which, of course, demands a trip back to
ooze.
One stealth mission involved our fuzzy burglar creeping past cockney-voiced trolls that seemed as if they could all of a sudden burst into the chimney sweep dance from Mary Poppins.
You can't expect folk to stop here just to be egged by you at birth.
Aside from a few depthful vistas, the characters themselves seem to suffer from relatively basic animation. They're just not that scary, tough, or good-looking enough to really involve you in the story. I mean, what are those things? Over time, you'll find the ancient pseudo-intellectual English purveyor of bad pop songs.
And I shall call you Sting!
As you gain power, your sword staff and stone throwing moves gain momentum, and well, you can probably figure out that you will then wield some tiny guy whoop-ass. This game seems to be a little too cartoony for us, from the damn near day-glow coloring to the awkward camera and fight moves. We're tossing this one close to Mount Doom. We give it a 2. Out of 5.
It was just a dream.
Don't I wish. No, the game is just a bad Zelda clone.
Sorry, Bilbo. No pipeweed for you. Colors aren't too bright as it is.
In a moment! Spinning our wheels in Crash Nitro Kart!
I have important information on how you can earn more money in the IT industry. Right now, businesses are desperate to hire certified IT professionals to secure their networks. You can fulfill this demand and make a great salary by getting IT certified now with Smart Certified Direct's fast and easy training courses. They're self-paced online training for MCSE, Cisco, and A-plus certification allows you to study whenever and wherever you want with 24-hour access to certified instructors, all with a 100% money-back certification guarantee. And right now, you can take a free training course title by visiting www.smartcertifieddirect.com or by calling 1-877-TRAINING and mentioning code TECHTV. There's no other obligation. That's on the web at www.smartcertifieddirect.com or toll free at 1-877-TRAINING. Get your free course today.
I just closed my home equity loan with Ditech.com. I don't need these anymore.
Want to pay off credit cards, consolidate debts, and lower your monthly payments? Apply now for a no-closing-cost home equity loan from Ditech.com.
You're right! This is fun!
Log on to Ditech.com or call 1-800-DITECH-1.
Every year, James Ward buys his mom the same old birthday cake. But this year, James switched to Progressive Auto Insurance. And if they can shake things up by creating an easier way to shop for car insurance, then maybe he too should swing for the fences. Nice work, James.
At Progressive, we're doing things to make shopping for car insurance easier. Visit Progressive.com, where you can see how we stack up against our competitors. You can compare prices and over 20 other facts and figures. You can even customize your policy, so you know you're getting the right amount of coverage at a great price. For over 65 years, we've been changing the way people think about car insurance. See for yourself at Progressive.com or call 1-800-PROGRESSIVE.
Looks like Mom's gonna have a pretty special birthday. Think easier. Think Progressive. Visit Progressive.com or call 1-800-PROGRESSIVE.
Raise the roof and secure the floors for Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Okay, we are back. with kart racing.
Woohoo! Okay, we already took a look at Crash Nitro Kart for the consoles, and now we're going to check out the portable version.
Yes, yes we are. Here's our review of Crash Nitro Kart for the GBA.
Brace yourself for Crash Nitro Kart!
The formula is simple. Take franchise favorites like Crash, Coco, and Crunch.
Just eat less and exercise more.
And pit them in madcap races against not-so-familiar enemies.
And conquer the world, of course.
Then sprinkle in the ability to hop, a few play modes, and a story that involves the evil intergalactic Emperor Velo kidnapping everybody.
Ruler of this galaxy.
And voila, you have an instant coffee break diversion and the basic premise of Sony's Crash Nitro Kart. But can this simple concept transfer from the PS2 to the GBA without losing any of the game's essentials? Surprisingly, yes. Originality isn't CNK's strong suit. Solid execution, however, is. Unlike most Mario Kart clones, this puppy makes provisions for warm-up boosts, power slides, and even performance-induced bonuses. However, due to the nature of the GBA platform limitation, these graphics are reminiscent of old childhood memories of kart racing back in the day. Actually, this is more reminiscent of childhood kart racing. But with new technology of anti-theft wheel locking, it's a lot safer to stick with the old Game Boy. The three racers you'll choose from before each competition sport inherent differences, as varying speed, acceleration, and turning attributes make handling each a unique experience. For example, Crunch has a pretty decent speed, but can't turn worth the shit. The title also makes great use of weaponry. If an enemy is out of range of your bomb, try the missile launcher. Now that's fun for the whole family. Despite platform and concept limitations, Crash Nitro Kart makes the most of what it's given. Sharp visuals, solid handling, and a rollicking soundtrack are joined by some slightly inventive play mechanics. Expect nothing out of the ordinary here besides a good old-fashioned arcade-style showdown. We give it a 4 out of 5. Now, if you want to read full reviews of any of the games you saw today, go directly to our website.
And I know where that is.
You do?
TechTV.com/xplay. Okay,
good.
We'll be back with something scary.
Whoa.
And it's nothing.
Coming up. Whimpering in fear over Fatal Frame 2.
Now this is big.
Find some of the greatest savings of the season during the big clearance sale at Radio Shack.
It's so big. It's
big savings of 25 to 60% on select toys, $20 to $70 savings on select audio and video, and 25 to 50% savings on select cool gadgets.
It doesn't get any bigger than this.
The big clearance sale at Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
I've got a question. How in the heck do I get down?
My PC just doesn't excite me anymore. I need one that knows how to perform.
Oh, you're gonna love this.
Gateway presents the Boost Your Performance with a Hot New PC Sale. Call now to get our powerful 310X desktop with the Intel Pentium 4 processor for under $600. With a CD burner DVD combo drive and a 17-inch monitor, it's the whole package at a great price. And powerful notebooks, they start under $1,000. Call now for free shipping on these and other hot new PCs.
Holiday's over, but the credit card bill's still coming?
Yep.
Need cash fast, huh?
Yep.
Try our e-loan home equity line to pay off those high-interest credit cards fast. In just 90 seconds, you could get approved to get the cash you need, and you'll have your money as quick as 12 days.
Hey, I'm approved already.
Needless paperwork? Gone. So you get cash fast at a great rate.
Great.
Nothing should come between you and a great rate. That's why there's e-loan. Apply now at eloan.com or call 1-800-ELOAN-22.
I moved to Earthlink because I only want the internet that's good for my kids.
Because I like being the guy you can always reach.
Because an Earthlink address makes a good impression.
I moved to Earthlink high speed because my life moves fast.
Because access should come with choices.
Different people, different passions, different reasons for moving to Earthlink. Whether you choose dial-up, high-speed, or wireless, make the internet your internet. Call 1-800-839-2988. We're currently offering 6 months of dial-up service featuring Earthlink Accelerator at half price.
I moved to Earthlink because they hate internet pollution as much as I do.
I moved because they block pop-ups. And I'll take all the help I can get.
Because Spam Blocker keeps my inbox neat and clean.
Speed, security, control. Your reasons are your own. Call, go online, or visit these retailers and get 6 months of dial-up service featuring Earthlink Accelerator at half price. Move to Earthlink. It revolves around you.
It's Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb.
Welcome back to X-Play.
All right, survival horror fans, and we got a game for you. It has twigs. Yes, a magic camera. Oh, yes. And it's going to scare the crap out of you if you play it with the lights out.
Instead of fighting evil with the gun, you use a camera. Okay, I know it sounds lame, but it's actually quite creepy.
All right, here's a review of Fatal Frame 2, Crimson Butterfly.
Mayu?
Ooh, I love butterflies and identical twins. I chase them just about anywhere, including a haunted village filled with evil. Sorry, I was about to review Fatal Frame 2, but then I got too busy wetting my pants in terror. Fatal Frame 2 tells the story of twin sisters, Mayu and Mio, who stumble into a bad, bad town.
People who get lost in the woods are trapped by the village. Could this be that place?
You're damn right it is. As Big Sister Mia, you'll wander around an ancient village in perpetual darkness, often followed by reluctant and occasionally clingy Mayu. Can you get out of my way? Hello? You'll soon find a flashlight and a highly unusual camera.
So this is the Camera Obscura. It takes pictures of impossible things.
An old photo box is an unlikely weapon, but if you have the patience, skill, and nerves to operate it, the Camera Obscura will serve you well against the supernatural. One button gets the camera ready, putting you in a first-person mode where you aim the viewfinder and shoot. And while you may flinch at getting too close to the attacking spirit, it's best to wait for the most opportune moment in your ghostly photo session to snap the picture. Capturing an opponent in their fatal frame just before a certain attack does heavy damage and sends the camera-shy spirits reeling. Work it, baby! Work it! That's right! Make love to the camera. Oddly, these fatal frames begin to resemble a series of really bad party photos at an out-of-control kegger. Where's the beer? Putting yourself in harm's way will earn you plentiful points with which to upgrade the camera and the special lenses you'll come across. It's nearly impossible for you to relax at any point in the game. You get the feeling that anything could jump out at you at any time. And sometimes, it will.
Would you cut that out?
During much of the game, particularly the masterful opening, the action is so gripping and well-plotted that you may not even notice you're being led around through a series of checkpoints and puzzles. On the downside, the game has its share of bad camera angles and eventually runs out of new enemies to scare you. Yes, yes, you're dead. Also, the girls seem to be constantly playing verbal tennis.
Mayu?
Mio?
Mayu?
Mio?
Mayu?
Mio?
Mayu?
Still, with a great core story, Fatal Frame 2 is a horror-themed title that anyone should consider playing with the lights off. We here at X-Play give it a spine-tingling 4 out of 5.
I really guys do scream like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we've said this so many times on the show, so I'm just going to do this slowly.
Okay.
For all the love of what is good in the world, please get rid of the bad camera angles. I know survival horror developers think it's a good idea,
right.
And you know what? It's not.
You know, you want to be able to see what's going on. It's very annoying. It's almost as bad as escort missions.
Nothing is worse than an escort mission.
All right, go to our website, techtv.com/xplay, and there you're going to find full reviews of all the games we looked at tonight, and also, you know, any game ever.
Yeah, let us know if you like bad camera angles.
Someone just might. You never know. I know. Good night.